8 acres. That's the size of the Memorial Park here at the World Trade Center site. But the emotion tied to this space feels limitless. For many pausing to observe the anniversary today, 2 decades will vanish. They'll be brought back to the horrifying events of a day they can never forget.
Apparently, a plane has just crashed into the World Trade Center.
20 years ago today, terrorists hijacked 4 commercial planes. 2 of the planes were crashed into the Twin Towers, which later collapsed. Another plane slammed into the Pentagon. Passengers aboard the 4th plane, United Flight 93, overpowered the hijackers, ending with a crash in Shanksville, Pennsylvania. In all, 2,977 lives were lost.
Amazing grace.
Somber remembrances are planned across the country, with President Biden and the First Lady expected to attend memorial events in New York, Pennsylvania, and Virginia. The White House releasing a video message encouraging Americans to mark the anniversary with acts of service in the spirit of unity.
In the battle for the soul of America, unity is our greatest strength.
Memorial events have already started taking place, like a wreath laying here by firefighters in honor of the 343 colleagues they lost on 9/11. Their sacrifice and those of all the first responders who gave everything to help others has never been forgotten. 20 years later, there is still progress being made in the effort to connect names to all the victims' remains, with 2 victims identified through DNA just this past week. Lester Holt talked to President Bush's national security advisor on 9/11, Condoleezza Rice.
Can you tell me that your thought process across the 20 years as you review what you knew, what the government knew, what it was able to do?
I'm convinced intellectually that we did everything that we knew to do, given what we knew at the time. But on a personal level, if you were in a position of authority, you feel remorse for that, because by definition, we weren't able to do enough.
20 years of perspective is something David Lim is incredibly fortunate to have. The retired Port Authority police lieutenant rushed into the North Tower to help with the evacuation. He and a handful of firefighters who had stopped in a stairwell to help a civilian managed to survive the collapse.
I remember coughing, and the only thought that came through my head was, dead men don't cough, I must still be alive.
On top of the 37 PAPD colleagues lost that day, Lim mourns the loss of his partner in the canine unit, a bomb-sniffing dog named Cirrus.
We carried him out of Ground Zero, and they treated him just like any other fallen first responder. I remember them folding up the flag and handing it to me, which is when I lost it.
As we mark this anniversary, the emotions are powerful, as if 20 years has not passed. And we're all brought back to the day America was attacked. Again, Savannah, Hoda, that ceremony set to start here around 8:30. We're told that some of the dignitaries and family members are already in place here at the World Trade Center. In fact, President Obama and former First Lady Michelle Obama just arriving a few moments ago. President Biden, Dr. Jill Biden expected here any moment. We're also being told that they are going to be visiting the museum behind me before the ceremony begins.
All right, Craig, thank you.
Hey, thanks for watching our YouTube channel. Find your favorite recipes, celebrity interviews, uplifting stories, shop our favorite deals, and so much more with the Today app. Download it now.